Good morning, my dear brother and sister. May I bless you this scripture as God has enabled us to wake up to face the day. My name is Reverend Arthur Omanyi of Buruburu Community Center. May I share with this wonderful scripture of scripture with you? But before we go to the word, let us pray. Jehovah God, our Creator, and the Creator of heaven and the earth, and your Creator to see, you created us in your image and likeness, so that we may serve you and have a close fellowship with you. Lord, we thank you for the day. My prayer is that you bless the brother or the sister who has chosen to walk with us through this scripture this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. So the word of God in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4 to 6 says, you are dead in transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. And God raised us up with Christ, and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. The word of God is very strange. It speaks diversely, speaking God's great mysteries, enabling us to understand what happened. So we thank God because the Bible talks of God being rich in mercy because of his great love with which he loved us. He loved us even before we knew him. He loved us even before we understood anything about him. He had already loved us. He'd already provided for our salvation, our healing, our freedom, redemption. He had already prepared a place for us. And so the Bible talks of his rich, God being rich in mercy because of his great love. Rich in mercy because of his great love with which he loved us. Even though we were dead in transgressions, he made us alive together with Christ. By grace, we are saved. We were dead, but he made us alive together with Christ. By grace are we saved. And he raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ. We have a very rich God, full of mercy, and God who has great love, God who cares for us, God who goes to any lengths to make sure our soul is not lost. If anybody will be lost, it's because they heard the truth and they rejected the truth. But to them who understand the length which God went to reach us and to provide that way of salvation, we gladly accept his son. We gladly accept his salvation. By faith are we saved, not by works. There's nothing good one can do to merit salvation. But when we understand that even when we were hopelessly in sin, defeated and down, he reached us. He didn't wait for us to be better people. He reached us where we were and then set us free by washing us with the blood of Jesus Christ. It is called the divine blood, the godly blood, sanctified and washed us clean. Not like the blood of the sheep, the goats, and the cattle, but the blood of his dear son, a godly blood, divine blood, blood that when he touches you and you surrender to him, it changes you, it gives you a whole new beginning. You live associated with God. You live related to God. You live connected to God. You live closer to God. You walk with him. Whatever you do, you are with him. And so he directs and alters your footsteps and even fights your wars because you have accepted his ways and he has come into your life and taken over your life because you have allowed him. And so he is rich in mercies and has great love for us. And it is the love which did all that. By his love, we can stand up and call ourselves children of God. And the Bible talks of We were not ready even for this. We were not even biblically correct for him to save us. While we were confused and not knowing what to do, he reached out to us and brought us closer. Now we have become children of God. We live by his statutes. We want to obey his word. We want to do his bidding. We want to love him just like he loved us and give ourselves to his services. So this God, who by his grace saved us through faith, we surrender to him and he changes us into wonderful people. Become powerful like his son, Jesus Christ. We are heavenly children, although we are still down here waiting for transformation and being transferred to the other kingdom. But we belong to it already because it was paid for. And you are the person to benefit from this wonderful provision of Jesus Christ. We thank God because he takes us up with Christ and seats us with him in the heavenly realms. We are seated on his right hand because we believe to him. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Father, we thank you for the message. And thank you for the heart that has heard and believed. Bless each one of them in Jesus' name. Amen.